Well, it depends on what I'm after.
Right? That's true. That's true. I've been called every name, Lord, Jesus, yeah. And shithead, and a whole bunch of things.
Absolutely. So these are some good boys here, huh?
This is Scotty Jackwagon Kugel.
How did I'm going to ask the million-dollar question? How did he get Jackwagon?
That was a nice. That was a nice nickname I gave him. Scott's a general contractor, same as I am. Uh-huh. And him and I actually met playing pool we played up in Hartford leagues, and he was always just a really quiet guy, and I never really talked to him. And all of a sudden, it was a topic we had a common denominator. And all of a sudden, we started talking, and next thing you know, we started kind of helping each other out with projects. And I was helping him out with a project down in Whitefish Bay. And he did not know that there's one thing that you never want to do with me, and that's play a practical joke.
Uh-oh.
So, yeah, it was a pretty big job. We were doing quite a bit at this house, and we happened to be doing some window replacements. And the windows, the old windows, I don't know if you're aware, if you take the sashes out there, you have a cord that's hooked to them with a weight.
Yep.
A big metal weight.
I replaced 42 of them in one of my duplexes. Absolutely.
Well, we had to take all those out and fill them with foam, but we took them all out, and they were all sitting on the side because he was going to turn them in, instead of throwing them out. And he decided to stick one of them in my truck on my seat as a little smart joke. Well, he found out the hard way that I'm the king of practical jokers, and
so he got the ball rolling.
Yeah, he got the ball rolling, and
that
was a very nice hit. Let's see if he got lucky with the leap. No. Well, I decided to get some window paint, some of that window marker that you put on that you can mark up on windows, right?
For sale.
Yes. Well, the next day when we were working at that job, I decided I had to head out a little early, and I went a proceeded to go to his truck, and with my nice window paint, I wrote on, he's got this nice big F-350 truck with this cab on the back that's got these really nice windows.
Okay.
And I proceeded to write Jack Wagon Construction, LLC, on the back of his truck and on the side of his truck. I drew a nice little wagon on the back and put on there, we specialize in making little wagons, and it was 1-800-JACK-WAGON is his number. And then I took two of those little weights that he decided to put in my truck, and I used the strings and I tied them to the bottom of his axles.
Oh, God.
So I waited till he came out, and it was funny because the neighbor had a friend over, and they were standing outside when we were going to leave. And I just had to sit in my truck and wait for him to leave. And sure enough, he comes outside, he sees the writing all over his truck, and he starts to laugh. And I'm thinking to myself, yeah, well, just wait till you start to drive away, buddy. And he proceeded to drive away, and all you heard was tink, 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 tink on the cement.
Sure.
And the lady who were doing the job for him, her friend, just turned around with this dumb look on her face like, what in the hell is that? That was another nice jump.
Yeah.
And he pulls over, and he just gets out, and he just starts laughing, and he realizes his weights are on the bottom of his truck, and just the funniest thing. So that's why I have a nickname as Jack Wagon.
Jack Wagon. So and I take it he cleared off, wiped off all the stuff on the windows before he took off.
He left it on there, till the next day. But it was funny because he actually
missed everything.
Yeah, went to pick up his son, who was this was probably about 3 years ago, and his son gets in the truck and he's looking at his truck and he said, "Dad, what is that? What's the Jack Wagon? Did you change your name on your business?" And he just started laughing. He's like, "No, I'll explain it to you."
Gotta love it. Welcome to life.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
I think Scott's actually kind of glad he missed that shot. Shot on the six anyway.
Mm-hmm.
These are some really tough shots to get the control.
D deep in the
speed
pocket,
on
right?
Yep.
Deep in the pocket.
And on the rail, because he's not going to realize how much this is going to come off that rail and shoot down that rail pretty fast. He actually did a pretty good job, but if you get it high enough,
Watch this.
Yeah, did that pretty well.
Yeah. Just like I would have done it.
Yeah, exactly. Right from this seat.
Absolutely. Yeah, take your choice. Six or the seven are both good.
Yeah, you get it. Yeah.
You ever play games where they give you balls? I mean, like a spot you to a six ball.
Yeah. Now,
does that mean that you're going to get the six, seven, eight, and nine if you make the six? Or is it just the six ball and a nine ball?
No
money balls.
No. If you get, are you talking about if you're
somebody spots you the six ball?
If you're spotting the six, once you get down to the six, if he makes it, the game's over.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
So any ball between the six and the nine would. So even if you got a 2-8, your game.
Yeah. Like that was not.
That
was not a good shot.
No.
He didn't really need to go that far with that. Yeah, if I actually played that way one time at it was one of the state tournaments we ended up playing, and there was a couple of us we played Scotch doubles, and we gave them the eight ball. So like we would run even if it's a six ball, if we run it down to the seven or eight, you know, if they make the next shot, it's in, it's done.
Okay.
So yeah, Scott's a really good player, strong double A player, and he actually just recently had the opportunity. Tyler Steyer put a post out there and said that they were taking six people to come to Vegas and actually do a Moscone-type camp with Oscar Dominguez, Tyler, and a couple of the others.
Sure.
And just so happened that Scott happened to see the post and he contacted Tyler, and Tyler's like, yeah, come on out. So he got a ticket for like $130. Round trip, went out there and got to shoot with Oscar and Tyler, kind of spend 2 days with them and shooting, and he said it was fantastic.
Yeah, how could it not be?
Yeah. It's awesome to see Tyler doing so well.
Yeah. Oh, I know. We've been having problems. I wonder if that rack's dirty. Pulling the one off.
Well, I saw like before when Larry, I know Larry's a good player, but what happens is, you know, they take the, if the ball doesn't set, they hold on to that one ball and they tap it. Yeah. Well, that creates a little divot in the felt, you know. Yeah. So as time goes on, if they start doing it all over the place, all of a sudden you get a bigger hole there.
Sure.
And you got to get to a certain spot where it keeps rolling back. You got to find that spot in it.
Yeah. Another one didn't look good on the break.
I try to, you know, I wash these tables down with really hot water to try to shrink that up and get those holes out of there. But sometimes if it's done too much, it's kind of tough to do. We'll see what Doug can do here. Pretty open table. I doubt he's going to go. He doesn't really have anywhere for that
two
combo,
2-9
nine combo. So you might have to try to run it instead of.
Or you just tap it back for a little draw.
Yeah.
Oh, you're gonna be screwed on the three.
Yeah,
you're gonna be screwed on the three with that.
I have to come across table for that three ball. But then get into a spot where you can hold it for the four ball too could be an issue. Actually, you know, where he's at, he's actually not bad. He puts some draw in that comes off by this diamond and floats it down to the bottom short rail down there. He'd have an angle to come back up for the four ball then. That's not what he wanted to do there. Yeah, that's not something he wanted to do there.
Try and sneak the cue ball back around the nine.
Yeah.
Or back up, center back up. No, three's going up.
He might try to make it. Yep, second thoughts on that.
Mm-hmm.
He could actually, if he played it right, he could actually just come off that three and sneak the cue ball in between the four and the nine and try to play safe on it. But you got to have the right touch on that too.
Absolutely.
Nine footers getting a little wild down there.
Are they?
Yeah.
Getting her done down there.
Yeah, hearing some screaming and hooting and hollering down there. Must be playing for that big money.
Yeah.
Dollar a game.
Buck and a beer. That would be the spot.
Yep.
That would be the spot. I like, what did he put on that, low right?
Yeah, it looked like he put a low right on it. Actually, okay. It almost looked like he might even just put bottom on it and hit it pretty full.
Hey, just get it back.
Yeah. Get that.
I got miles of it at home. Don't worry about it. Yeah.
What was Stefan trying to hook up?
Oh, some TV, some TV over there. Because I knew I had a short one around here somewhere. I just don't bring coax anymore.
Yeah.
But I happened to pick that TV up. The coax was still sitting in the bottom of the.
Nice hit. Touch. Really nice hit.
Won't like the leave, but
no.
Nice touch.
At least got the hit off of it. Now, if he doesn't play this right, he could run in that four and run in the same problem as he did with that three ball. I don't know what kind of angle he has on that, but
got a little angle there. Yeah, enough to hit the four.
Yeah.
Unless he can guarantee to go that side of the four,
right,
far
yeah.
side of the four.
Right.
Yeah, you're gonna hit it no matter what you do.
Yep. Yeah, he's gonna. Yeah, looks like the angle. He's gonna run right into that four ball. Almost a shot here would be kind of. I'll see if you draw it back, you're risking the chance of going back towards that pocket and burying yourself behind the nine ball.
Rail nine corner.
Yeah, that looks like that's what he's gonna do. Trying to draw it back, come off that rail, but hopefully he doesn't get stuck behind that nine ball. Cause that's. Oh, see, when you don't stroke through it, that's what happens. That's basically you're hitting center ball there.
Yeah.
It'll make it there.
Yeah. Let's see. Try to play safe somewhere.
Eight ball.
Oh, scratch. Oh, wow.
Right back. Look at that.
Oh, did he get away with it?
No.
Nope.
I don't think so. No. Got the shot.
Now it looks like he can see that, yeah.
Got the shot.
Now he even moved that six ball closer to nine now for that combo.
Yep.
Scott's a good player. You can't give him too many opportunities because he'll run out on you. Yeah, as the balls go flying.
Yeah. Duck. This should be a short game here.
Yes, there it is.
Yep. So the Jack Wagon is off to a Twitter race.
Yeah, the Jack Wagon is off. Off to a fast start.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just played against Doug. It was a Scotch doubles down at Shepherd's.
Okay.
A couple weekends
ago.
Yeah,
I know. I wanted to get in. I was going to play with who the heck it was. We backed out at the last minute. So I couldn't
play. Because you're supposed to see me down there. Yeah.
Yep.
And him and Terrence Beck played together. And
oh, okay.
It's one of those where he's a good shot maker. He's a great shot maker. Like as you saw with the jumps,
sure.
It's like he can make some great shots, but the ball pattern is where he lacks it. You know, if he could pick better ball patterns, he might be a much better player. You know, but a lot of times that's with a lot of players. You know, it's just you got to learn that ball pattern skill. And
yep. And I was playing up at Matt Hatter, not Matt Hatter,
Matt Apple.
Yeah, I keep calling him Matt Hatter.
Same
they're all mad there. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, it's all mad.
I was playing with Barry Chapman on it.
Oh, yeah.
It was on the tournament. I was breaking and running. I'm playing eight ball, which I don't particularly do all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And Dean was up there. He says, "Will you knock it out?" You know, I said, "Well, I'm just warming up."
Dean.
Pete.
Pete Hurt?
No, Pete. What's his name? Pete. He's pushing all the tournaments up there. I can't remember his last name. Deaton.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And we were playing before the match was up, and I got a break. Had him sprawled all over the place, and I said,
really?
"Barry, what would you take first on the shot?"
Mm-hmm.
The hardest thing for me is always finding a pattern.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you do this, you do that, you do this, you do that, and then it's like, And then somebody else walked by, and that was Tyler was there.
Oh, was he?
Yeah. So he comes by and says, where do you shoot? Well, I do it this way, that way. It was totally opposite of what Barry was saying. Well, whatever. Yeah. Everybody sees the table different. How do you think you're going to get there?
I don't think he called a push. I don't think he called a push on that shot.
I think he did.
No, he didn't. Nope. He didn't call a push. He was trying to go for a hit. So I was wondering, this guy was looking the way he was looking at it. I thought maybe he did, but usually it's, you know, because I didn't see him turn to him and say push. But heat of the moment on the stream table. Probably got nerves on him. It'll be all right. Scott is the master of stun shots.
Is he?
Yeah. Watch it. I mean, this is one thing. Center ball. Watch his shot. He'll just float it over with center ball punch.
Sweet.
Yep. I tell you, that is a shot that, believe it or not, most players, they should play 5 games in a row just hitting nothing but center ball.
We were talking about that earlier.
Don't care where you leave it. Just hit center ball every single time. Basically, like play straight pool.
Yep.
Don't play it. Don't play any solid stripes. Just play straight pool and hit every ball you can.
Yep.
Center ball. It helps you learn the way that cue ball will go without English.
Reacting.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
No, it's kind of funny because one of my shots that I do occasionally will be a. You get a ball where you're like parallel down close to the rail. Maybe you're between half first diamond and the short rail.
Mm-hmm.
And you're rail to rail just enough so I can put some draw on it or something. And for whatever reason, and sometimes I don't know how the hell I do it, it'll never hit a rail, but it'll just 90 degree walk right up. I got to come back up for the five ball, and I just park it right up the rail or up the table like that. And it's like, holy kajibers, how the heck did I do that? Yeah. Put that in the memory bank.
Yeah,
stroke.
Exactly. How did I pull that out of my butt?
Yep.
Ooh.
And then I do something like that.
Yep. Oh, he might get lucky. He sure did.
Look at this.
Hey, that's the professional skill there. Oh, wow.
Yeah, the pool gods are in love.
Yes, absolutely. Oh, he looks like he might try that.
Let me see if I get a shot. He'll be in the front of the camera. I don't know.
Yeah, he's going to have to get. That's a tough shot. That is a very tough shot to do.
You better hit it with the breeze going by.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's thinking about it.
Because if he hits it too solid, he's going to leave it in perfect shape there for Scott.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. I was thinking of the nine.
That's what I'm saying. Either carry him off the five ball into the nine. Yeah. But if he hits that nine solid, if he clips it just a little bit too much and hits that nine solid, he's gonna leave Scott in a perfect shape there to get the eight out of there. Because you got to come to this side for the eight, because that's right at that spot where it's that the nipple's in play. Trying for it or not, can't really see. Looks like he might be.
Yeah. I don't think I can get this shot.
He tried it.
Yep.
He tried it, but unfortunately was unsuccessful.
Yep.
Yeah, Scott and I, we went to actually ACS down in Vegas this year.
Oh, how'd you like it down there?
Oh, it was awesome. It was a really good time. But it was funny because two years ago, a buddy of mine who I golf with, he's now retired. He worked at a law firm. So it was my buddy Bob, the guy who works as an attorney, Tim.
Mm-hmm.
They worked at the same place, and I got to know Tim through playing basketball. And long story short, we started golfing together. We used to play at Brown Deer like every Sunday. Well, Bob retired, and he decided to get a membership at a place out in Kenosha. Well, him and his wife in the wintertime, they decided that they were going to start snowboarding.
Okay.
Scott's up through it. So they started to pick different spots, and 3 years ago, they decided to rent a condo out in Mesquite, Nevada, which is about an hour west of Vegas.
Okay.
And so I was going to KBiz, which is a kitchen and bath show in Vegas, and I went there early. And I went out there early, stayed with Bob. We went golfing. Tim came out there. We went golfing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there was a day that we weren't golfing, and Bob had something to do, so I had a rental car. So I decided to go find. I just wanted to ride up in the mountains.
Sure.
I just love just taking drives and just going. Well, I found this really nice path that took me up into the mountains, and there was some great spots, some great views. And I went up there, drove till I couldn't see anymore, and it was getting dark out, turned around, came back.
Jack, are you in here?
Well, when Scott and I went out to Vegas, our team got busted out of nine ball pretty early.
Mm-hmm.
So we had kind of a whole day to do something, and I just happened to mention to him, I said, hey, told him about this spot by Mesquite.
Mm-hmm.
So we decided to go up there, and we took the same path and went along the same way. Well, we got to a certain point where I actually stopped and turned around. Well, we had plenty of daylight left, right?
Yeah.
So we found a map that was on the path. And we're like, oh, well, if we take this route, we go that route, we can come back around, we'll come ball loop right back around. This will be fun. Let's do it.
Okay.
Yeah, well, we need to, off the videos that we had, we need to make a commercial because there were some of the pathways that were up in the mountains. We literally had 2 feet before we were falling off the edge.
Ooh.
And we were going over these boulders. Oh, it was just the funnest time. It was so fun because we had no idea if we were getting home that night or not.
Sure.
Because it was like that bad.
But yeah.
It was just the best time. That was a nice shot.
Have you ever been around Lake Hebgen out in Montana?
Mm-mm.
Oh. That's
one state I haven't been to yet.
I used to live out there.
Really?
A little place called Red Lodge. Actually, Roberts, but it was close to Red Lodge. It's now this huge ski resort.
Is it really?
There was nothing there when I was there. But I was elk hunting. And
I'd still want to do that.
Yeah, it was fun. Work. Better put some ankle weights on before you go. I'm not saying you're old or anything.
Yeah,
but
no.
But you better be in shape chucking the mountains. But around Lake Hebgen, that's up around, I lived around Billings, Roberts.
Mm-hmm.
This was up to, it's the middle of the state. I forget. Anyways, there had been an earthquake out there in maybe 53, 52, 53,
oh, really?
Something like that. And you're walking on this trail, it's maybe about as wide as this table. And as you're going up, all of a sudden you hit this brick wall. And literally you'll look it up on Wiki or something, this whole section of land just dropped like 10 feet.
Really?
There were deaths, and there was crazy time out there. And I'm like, how do we get out of here now?
Holy
there
cow.
Was no you, down here, it's down there.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
There was no way to walk out of the dumb thing.
Wow.
So it's around go back, but it was interesting. Yeah, Lake Hebgen, that was what happened.
I've heard it's beautiful out there.
It is absolutely gorgeous. I truly loved it out there. Then one of my clients is John Deere years ago and went up around Lake Louise area, Vancouver.
Wow, nice.
Just something else.
Jack, your final call before I forfeit you. If you or anybody in here knows him, he's got a couple minutes before I move on.
Mm.
What's the matter?
Missing another player.
Oh, boy.
I don't know. Ask Dan.
Let's go to that table over there.
Huh?
Oh, you're funning.
Curtis Harbin. Good guy.
Yeah. I know I'm down at Shep's. He hangs out down there, isn't
yep.
it? He hangs out with Shepherds.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. He hangs out with Petey Hurd and Kenny Williams.
Yep. Yeah.
I saw him. He was out at Nationals too, in Vegas. And
yeah.
Good guy.
Yeah, he was saying he doesn't play nine ball.
Yeah.
He just doesn't like the game.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Some people don't like rotation. You know.
I love it.
I do. I love it too.
Yeah.
I like 10 ball. 10 ball is
yep.
is the game. Are you going up to the Hall of Fame?
I will not be there. We had talked to John about streaming up there, but didn't get an answer. So Though it's next week, it's a little late.
Yeah, I think, I don't know who, I'm almost positive.
Did on the rail or something? I don't know. I don't know if Duff has enough to do it. Well, he's got the table.
I think he might have bought his own equipment.
Duff?
Yeah.
Oh, he did on his table. I know he improved his picture or whatever. I don't know what he's got.
Well, Duffer's not part of that anymore.
He's not.
I heard he's out. I heard it's just...
We better not talk bad about him then.
I just heard it was... that's the rumor I heard. Okay. I don't know if it's true, but that's... what I heard was Kendall is his primary now.
Really?
I don't know why Duffer got out of it, but...
He's a good shot. We played against him. We got beat Michelle and Duff and whatever that team was. Wisconi Cup.
Oh, Wisconi.
Yeah.
Michelle was on that team?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Michelle's a good person. She's really cool.
Yeah.
I mean, it's amazing. There's a lot of good people in the pool committee. I was asked this first. This is the first time, and I don't know if you've ever heard of the Milwaukee Premier League? Craig Green?
I have heard of it. I don't know much of anything about it.
Lyle McDowell, they call him Champ because he was actually a championship boxer.
Oh no! Look at that! Wow, perfect position.
Yeah, pro position there.
Perfect position.
Lyle McDowell, great guy. Mm-hmm. But he texts me this year and he's just like, "Hey, Brian, you said you'd do anything for me. I need you to do something for me. I want you to play on my team in the Milwaukee Premier League." I said, well, when is it? On Sundays. So I said, well, I've got my son every other weekend, so I could commit every other weekend or, sure. You know, here and there.
Yeah.
And I tell you what, it's amazing. You got a lot of these plays are down on Capitol and Titonia. Yep, Doug got a game there, 3-1. A lot of these places are, you know, down on Titonia, Capitol, you know. Yeah, where people would say the not so good areas.
Okay.
But I tell you what.
They're recovering.
Exactly. Yeah. I tell you what. I told Craig. I saw him at Shepherd's when I played on Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, I said, you know what? Honestly, Craig, I love shooting in that league because I have met some really cool people that league. Great people.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and it's amazing how sometimes you think to yourself, you know, I don't know this area. And you go and play and it's just like, yeah, there's some great people. Yeah. Great people.
Yeah. A friend of mine shoots on our team on Tuesdays. He went down to Cleveland. They do a couple of football games a year. They went down to Cleveland. They wanted to see the Browns win their first game, you know, just this spring.
Did they get the beer?
No, he wasn't there. He went down last year. Packers played him the last game of the year. Last game or something like that.
Yeah.
Can you mention he's the gunslinger?
Who?
The gunslinger.
Who?
So he goes down there. He says, "I've never met a bunch of people who like to tailgate as much as those guys." I said, "Have you been to Lambeau or Dyla Brewer Stadium?" You
know? Yes, Lambeau especially. Because I tell you, it's amazing how there's so many houses just around Lambeau that you can go there and pay $20 or $30 and party all day long
for free food and
alcohol.
Yep.
I'm not a huge, huge drinker, but if I was, that's a place I'd go.
Stays down.
Another technical question coming out from another table. Since we're sitting with the TD.
Got to answer those questions.
Absolutely.
Dang it all.
Well, you know, it's good they come and ask.
Right.
Instead of sitting arguing over the over at the table, just come and ask.
That's
the name of the game.
Nice shot.
But I went a number of years back. My wife won a trip to Arizona for Brewer spring training. I'm talking 25 years ago, maybe. Well, actually, because George Bamberger and Vukovic were still playing, so it was about 80 something in there.
Okay, so remember those years?
Yeah. So we go down there, and I tell you, how could I not go to a Brewer game in nice weather and want to burn a couple of brats?
Right.
That's all I wanted. So we were shagging around all these grocery stores. We could not find a brat, let alone some buns, and then a little portable charcoal grill. Yeah. I ended up buying whatever the heck I bought, a couple of big bags of charcoal because that's all I could get. You know?
Did you finally find the brat?
I did find something. I don't know if it was a sausage patty or what the heck it was.
It looked like one, so that's all that matters.
Yeah. But people were sitting behind the cars in a gravel parking lot back then. put a little blanket down, but you know, we're out having a good time. People are like, what are you doing?
tailgating.
Don't you know anything about this?
What the hell is that?
Exactly.
That's too funny.
That was a hoot.
Oh. Yep. Well, you broke that out too for him.
That's the trouble with doing that shot, especially so close.
I'm
not a jumper, but
it's almost with that. I mean, especially since those balls are tied up and kind of holding the table up a little bit. It's almost better to just try to kick at that and get it because either way, if you're going to foul, you're not breaking it up.
Right. That's a mentality of Scott's down the road.
Scott's got to be careful and make sure he gets down below. Yep,
look at that.
Nice.
Great shapes. Look at this.
Yep. Yeah, Scott's got a lot of knowledge. He's got a diamond table in his house, and I go to his house, and it's funny. We play a race to eight all the time for a buck.
Oh.
And he's
afford it?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
He's one of these guys that just the nicest down to earth guy, and sure. He will, if you sit there and play with him, he'll teach you anything you want to know. Like,
cool.
There's that group I was telling you about that just started out here in the leagues.
Sure.
You know, he sees them struggling, and he'll just sit there and say, "Hey, here's something for you. And show you something." And those are the kind of people I like to surround myself with. You know,
absolutely.
The good people that.
Look at this. All around the table, never touched a piece of real estate. Sweet.
Yeah. He's got
got
a great stroke.
Good stroke.
At times the one thing I have about that punch shot.
Yep.
He's just got such control over that punch shot.
Back.
One thing with Scott, and he'll even admit it. He admits he does it sometimes. Sometimes he gets a little too cute with things. You just come off one rail, but he'll decide to spin it and go around three rails. You know what I mean? But that's just common. It's a lot of it. And he's got such a great stroke that he feels that he can do it. And sometimes he admits, he's like, sometimes I just get too cute with something because
You're feeling it.
Yeah, you're free stroking, and all of a sudden you get that spot of, oh yeah, I can spin this
cake.
Yep. And it comes up just a little short.
Or a little long.
Yeah, or a little long.
I'm more of that style.
Get up there. Yeah, came a little short on
there
that.
There you
one.
Go.
He was afraid of coming in between those and that, running into that eight ball possibly. Yeah, he might. This is close. If he's got to put a little spin on that tonight.
Calling a third diamond for position, huh?
Yeah.
Look at this guy, third diamond. Look at this.
Yep. Good shot. He looked a little closer to the rail than he wanted to, but
yep.
He still got positioner to come straight back over to this rail. Speed is the key here.
Yep, especially on these days. He's going to hold it.
I don't know why he's a. It must be not as much of an angle as I'm thinking it is.
Ooh, there's that draw stroke you were talking about.
Yep. Now, when you hit it well, sometimes it just goes too far. But I did talk to
a back angle. I hate back angles.
I know.
Back cutting.
Yeah. It's amazing how many times you actually undercut those.
Oh yeah.
Bobby's got to be careful with the nice. Hold it. Ooh. Hold it. Yeah, that's good.
Got
that's
enough awesome. Gas. Nope.
That was good stroke. I did talk to Larry, and I don't know when he's up, but he said he's willing to come up here soon and chat a little bit. So
cool. Hey, everybody loves Larry. I said that already.
Yeah, I haven't really, I never really talked a lot with Larry. I've seen him before, but never really talked to him too much. But just over the last 2 days, last night and today, talking to him, he's just down to earth guy.
He really is. Yep, he really is. I take it he's still winning, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's still winning. I think him and... I jumped right in there.
Come on, look at this. Wow. Oh, what a table.
He's got a great break. Well, this is a key shot here, the two to come back up for that three. if he plays it right, pretty easy run. Let's see that five ball there again. That five ball
sitting
was in a position.
Bad space,
yeah, sitting in a bad spot.
Let's see.
He's almost got to get up here for that three ball and draw straight back on that rail.
I was going to say, take the angle of two in the corner and try to come around behind the nine ball.
Yep.
Back up.
And yeah, either come up to the hit the six ball in to maybe come back up with the five ball or
I didn't even see the six in there.
Draw it back so you're up against that rail and then take the five down straight down. But again,
that is a tough shot. You got a little bit of space between that five there, but not much.
They're the worst positions on those when those balls are right there near that side pocket.
Mm-hmm.
Get up there.
That'll be all right.
Yeah. Well, it depends on how he wants to hold it, though, and where he wants to go with the five.
Yep.
It'd be a little easier if he was a little closer. He could hold it against this rail. Now he's going to have to give it some spin.
He's going to have to go 5-6.
Yeah.
Come down.
And that's good because the angle he has right here, unless he gets a lot of spin on it, that's going to be a tough shot to get straight down now. Oof. Missed it.
Isn't that rule number one? Make the ball.
Make the ball. don't punch. Don't punch at
that's
it.
That's me. Give a little extra. Shove it
me
in the
too.
Hole.
It happens.
get used to the sewer pockets on the valleys.
Yeah, see, this guy he's probably gonna play a safe here. I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Nice shot.
Yep.
I don't know if you can see that or not. Can't tell if he can see if he's got.
I'll see.
Even if he's got a beat on that still.
Yeah, I don't have anything low enough.
You can't. There's not a real good save because that three balls. Oh, he's just gonna tie it up.
Sometimes that's what you gotta do.
Yeah. Well, I see a real easy save from here though, and Scott sees it too. Just knock that three ball on the other side of the eight, which will knock the seven out of there.
Yep.
And stop it right there. Now, looks like he's going to hit it soft, just get it past the eight ball. And then run right into the eight to keep it there. Yep, just like that. Now, I have a feeling Doug, if he can't see, he's probably just going to try to tie him back up.
Let's see. Yeah, you can ball in hand, you'll just see the three, so.
Yeah. Oh, why is he doing that? He's getting that five off the rail? Oh, wow. That's a shocker. I'm really shocked at that one.
Yeah.
Because now you just kind of freed up a trouble ball.
Absolutely.
This is pretty easy for Scott. All he's got to do is just give it a little draw, knock the seven ball out of there, and it'll have the five in the side now.
Yep. Yeah, you gave it a home.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if he's got some room in between that eight ball to get a little.
You're going to probably, not on a draw, I mean, it depends how good your stroke is, but it's pretty close to being on the rail. You can get out of there, but if you hit it a little off where the rail comes into play, you're going to, the eight ball probably pop out and still get the five.
Yeah, if you put, he's going to go the other way with it.
Gonna break. Well, no three foul rule. But
no. He's just gonna put some straight top on that to keep it along the rail, and it's gonna knock that seven ball out, and then have the five ball on the side.
Yeah.
All right, play a safe.
Safety.
There you go. That's a nice shot there too.
Mm-hmm.
So now he freed it up completely.
That is a seven doable.
Yeah, seven looks like he can go down in that corner down there. Oh, he's got the five ball to break that up because the six ball's a sitting duck. So now it's not a sitting duck anymore.
Don't think I'd be. I don't know if I would have done that.
I don't know if I would have either. But looking at it though,
still got to earn it. But
yeah.
But.
But made it just a little easier.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, if he stays on this side of the five, a little scoot forward for the seven.
Yeah, looking on hindsight, that actually might not have been too bad of a shot because now he puts Scott in a position where if he can't see that seven ball there, he's got to put himself in a good position to be able to break that out and still have a shot. Whereas with the six ball, if the six ball had been there, Scott could be a little free with it. And, you know, all you'd have to do is run into the seven ball and not worry because he's got the duck there for the six. So. All right.
Yep.
Now he's making Scott think a little more. I think Scott would love to get up right up this diamond across here.
Mm-hmm.
Give it a little bit of an angle, so all you do is make the five and the side run right into the middle of the seven and eight to push them both either way. But the thing you don't want to do, though, is push the eight and leave it, you know, dead on
or
that rail.
Come back.
Yeah,
hit it hard enough
to bring the eight off the rail so seven ball kicks up towards the corner pocket there. Looks like he needs to try to draw it behind the backside of the nine. I think he'd want try to rub into it. Well, unfortunately, just
that
changed
didn't
pace.
Work out.
No, just changed the places with him.
Yeah.
Yes, good try, but he actually could get it here. He put some top left on it, hit that rail down, diamond down there
at
the bottom.
The nine doesn't come in a
play. Yeah, just got to make sure he misses a nine, come around there. And he almost
playing it.
Now he can let the nine ride if he wants.
Yeah.
The nine will go straight back over here if he hits it right. Or do that. Good shot.
Yep.
Good save. this is the kind of thing that'll frustrate the lower players when they keep getting safe like that.
I'm here.
You can tell it just the way he's been knocking in those balls, he's getting frustrated.
Yeah.
You can't let it get to you.
No.
It's part of the game and just do the best you can to try to make a good hit.
You probably end up giving the game up, but if you practice your hits,
Eventually it'll work out.
Yeah. Oh, watch this.
Wow.
Oh, I thought he was going to come
up. I thought he was too.
That's still a good hit. Good lead.
Yeah, absolutely.
On the rail, though, he'll come back up and break those two up if he makes her.
Yeah, he doesn't even really need to. He doesn't really need to.
He can make the eight, yeah.
Oh, is it 8 o'clock?
Time to do something.
I got to go call the break pot tickets on the 50-50, so I'll be back
in
a minute.
Fine. Here we go with a little action.
Ron Lessig, Joe Mucci, table three.
I'm going to do it on this table.
Are you going to stop play then, or what are you going to do?
No, I'll continue to let play go, but once this match is done, I'll probably do the break out here on this table.
Okay. great bank shot, Scott.
$75 for the winner. We're going to let someone that's not in the tournament take it. Shelly. Oh, we're actually here. What was your name again? Melissa. We're going to have Melissa take the ticket. So whoever is the winning ticket, you give her a nice big kiss. I mean, Mark. No, I'm just kidding, Mark. All right, the 50-50 winning number is 142-367. Wow. 142. Don Whipper. Tickets. We're going to pick two of them, so if the first person does not get anything, then the second person will be allowed. Oh yeah, Allison. Allison gets the pick. Mix them up, mix them up. Allison will pick one and Shelly will pick the other one. Alright, this is the first one. Is the second one. So my left hand, which is the first one, is ticket number. Is somewhere in the name on the back? No. Nope. All right, ticket number 389705. That's the first one. 389705. Mike, okay, Mike's got the first one. The second one is 389805. Vanessa? Vanessa got the second one. Good thing you stayed. Well, that's it, Mike, your eye breaks.
Thank you.
Joe Mucci. Going on 10 minutes. Last call. Joe Mucci.
Thank you.
my Friday night all the time.
Trying to find the dissolve.
Sean Rohrer, table 8. I don't know what you're waiting for.
This is your last call. This is your last call.
Back from the technical duties.
Yeah. I hit it when that happens.
I know. I tell you, they're so demanding, these players.
I know.
Doug's on the hill.
Yep, this is now, it used to be a 3-2 race. Now it's a 3-1.
3-1.
Yeah. That, he is, I got to say, Doug has not been getting a lot of breaks in this game.
No.
And Scott's gotten quite a couple of good ones.
Yeah.
That's tough. It's tough, though, to stay there in good spirits and middle of the table. No.
Then there's that 1-9 combo that might look pretty good about right now, because that 4-ball and that 5-ball and 7-ball do not look very nice.
That's a little cluster.
Yep. Problem is, you almost, like I said, again, this is a point where you better hit this one a little hard, because if you hit it soft, then you might look at... this is the hill game for him, and he could win pretty easily at that point if you don't hit this hard and get that one ball cleared out of there. And don't let the 9-ball sit in the pocket, because if you do.
Yep. Get the magnets out.
Yeah, exactly, because everything's going to be flying.
Well, if you're going to swing hard, you might as well go after the breakout.
Yeah, exactly.
All in one.
Yep.
Center ball going for the win.
Oof.
It's all right.
Well, hey.
Hard enough to get it out.
Exactly. Yeah. Got it out, and now there's some work to be done.
Mm-hmm.
Those are tough, especially when you gotta cut it so much like that. Those are tough combinations.
Settle down.
You got into that one a little too good there.
Yeah.
Like I said, though, Doug's one of these guys. He's a shot maker. So yeah, he'll put himself in a position, but he's a shot maker.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
May not take the right ball patterns or get to that position he needs, but he can make the balls.
Works himself out of it.
Yep. He might be able to get the breakout. Oh, he was worried about the breakout, not making the shot.
No.
I've never done that before. How about you?
Never. In a million years would I ever think about doing that.
Don't understand how they do that. You neither? I can see the look in your eye. Like, what?
He's glazed over. Not even drinking.
That's from 420, isn't it?
Yeah. They say eyes wide shut.
Right. Yeah, Scott with his English, he might be able to come around and break.
Oh, watch this, yeah.
Oh, he did the same thing. See?
Yep, look at this.
That
was not good.
No, it's actually, he's not probably glad he did not make that.
Mm-hmm.
You had to hit that one a little harder to make sure you got out of that cluster.
But even then, I don't know if he would have made the four.
Yeah, I don't.
Five, I don't know.
Tough run on that one.
Yep.
If you look at Doug's tip, it's like he almost needs a tip. You see
mushroomed?
That?
Yeah. He's down to a little.
He's like down to nothing.
Yeah. There it is.
Wow. Here's what happens. Yep. Yeah, you might as well just. That's jail. That is jail right there. But the thing about it is, you don't want to hit these balls and break them off.
Yeah, but if you do a nice, soft, short rail come in back door, and I think the four is off the rail.
Yeah, it looks like it's off the rail, but that's going to be tough to squeeze that in.
Oh, plenty of room in there. Oh, gosh, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm trying to squeeze it past and get that right angle, because you're going to have to hit it almost at that diamond. You got to have spin coming off
the short rail.
You got to have a lot of spin to get it.
Yeah, if you put too much on, you're never going to get back there.
No. That's, yeah, no.
But all in all.
Exactly, that's a tough one there. It's.
Go topside. Yeah, put him back in the same spot.
Yeah,
send him running.
Try to get that left, so just got to make sure you don't scratch. You know,
right.
I don't know if he's going to try to hit that and get it up table, or if he's
I would think that's where I would be going. No, he's high left.
Oh, there you go. That's actually not a bad shot right there. It's a nice shot.
Mm-hmm.
This is, now he doesn't
five's
have
a blocker.
Yep, five's a blocker, and he's going to have to, can't come through that six and seven.
Or come, but I can't.
I don't think he's getting through that six and seven.
May not make a hit, I don't think. Or you could spin the heck out of it.
Yeah, that's so tough trying to get all that left spin and then trying to, because if you hit it too hard, you know that cue ball immediately shoots to the right with that left spin. But if you hit it too soft, it's going to curl too soon. You know.
He's coming in on the right side.
You know, plow the balls in there and tie them up.
Yep. I agree. Things that make you go,
He's going to, you know what? He's going to knock that four ball out of there and leave it right there.
Yep.
That's a good shot.
Yep. Wing that five ball around.
Yeah, jeez.
park it right in there.
That was nice.
That would have come back in front of the cue ball. It was like.
It actually did. Well, not that he had a path anyway, but that definitely blocked the path for. Oh, he's going to try to knock the five in now. Yeah, this is a pretty easy.
Yeah, the breakout there is not that bad.
Yeah.
You play it in the side, our side, near side here.
Yeah, he's gonna kind of come into it. But the problem you run into there is if you don't hit that hard enough, you got too much spin, you're gonna set yourself behind that nine ball.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah, you got no control.
You got no control.
That's why I would have shot this side. This
come
side.
The opposite way. Yep.
Little follow and use the nine to pop the two of them out. Hopefully, leave a six shot in the corner. But hey, my plans are all screwed up.
Right?
At least that's what everybody tells
plan
me.
Plan B.
Absolutely.
Like I said, middle name would be Plan B.
Yep. Well, he likes that coming in back door stuff.
Yep. Yeah, I don't know if he's going to come to that short rail and come back up, or if he's going to try to hit the nine ball first.
He's up high enough.
Oh.
Well, right back where he was.
Well,
he got a shot.
You know what? Honestly,
didn't kill himself.
No, he didn't kill. No, exactly. Now he's given him a peek at it where he may try to cut it and try to break those
coming
balls out.
Mm-hmm.
What's up?
Not much.
Brian, how can I get one of those fancy Sussex
Bull
shirts?
Well, this one's a McDermott one. We got new shirts coming for Sussex. I'll show you the new ones. They're pretty nice.
Yeah, I like to see one.
All right.
I might wear one tomorrow.
Oh, he scratched on that, huh?
Yeah, I turned my head. Yep.
Yeah, when I went and met with McDermott, I asked him, I said, hey, I want to wear one for the tournament. So this was originally $65. It gave to me $35. Nice. They're the new ones.
Wouldn't even comp you out, huh?
Look at this.
That's a nice set. Oh.
Lively rails.
Almost perfect, yeah. Almost perfect. Yeah, he pushed that six up in there, Lewis. That's going to be a little tougher now to get that out. This is going to be a little safety battle here.
Yeah, I'm thinking.
Let's see. The difference is, though, is I think Doug is going to try to go. Wow.
Ooh.
Wow, that was a good stroke.
Yeah, it was.
Well, the problem is he's a little close to that six ball now. I may have to go watch his shot. Yeah, I got to go watch his shot.
All right. Tied up? No. Okay. TD's job is never done.
You got a lot of viewers? How many viewers do you actually
have? Not a lot, really.
No?
No.
I should share.
a link or something that I can share on Facebook.
We do. We're already on. We share it on Facebook. We got a stream on our website and YouTube. And he was on there. Just pushing it on Facebook.
Right.
And then Kelly was on for a while. She was chatting. Who knows? People just got to get used to it. Get a name out there, and that'll be that. That's why somebody was here. Well, we did have somebody in there.
Sorry.
We had somebody on one of the URLs. They were in North Carolina or something like that. Wanted to see what was going on. So.
And that was a good shot. Pretty easy kick shot. Come off that rail, just gotta make sure you get hidden by the nine ball there. Scott likes to put spin on the ball, so he'll probably get out of this. He won't get stuck behind that nine ball. Yep, that was a nice shot right there. Wow, that was a really nice shot.
They don't think they got a shot. They're
going to
just go and
watch. Oh, a little long. Yep.
But are the banks open on Saturday?
Yeah. I think he's going straight
make
up.
Make a deposit here? You're going to make the cut.
He likes cutting these shots. He's... Yeah, straight in. He likes those shots.
That's all right.
All right, seven.
Keep me up here.
Seven to three.
Yeah.
2-1 race. With the break.
Yep. Kind of going all your way.
Yeah.
Go to Hill.
Yep. Yeah, Scott's got he's got a great break, like I said before. If he can keep it on, if he can keep that cue ball on the table, and yeah, he'll pocket. He'll probably pocket at least two or three balls.
You a straight on breaker or a diamond breaker?
I'm straight on. I can, you know, that second ball break, I just cannot stand when you don't hit it good. It piles everything to one side of the table. I've had such success with head on breaks that. You know, and actually, it's funny because these tables here, believe it or not, with an eight ball rack, the third ball is actually the best ball to break here on these tables.
Really?
Third ball.
Really?
Yep. This
because of the liveliness.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, he's got a shot.
Yeah, he made two balls. I'm sorry, I was off. He made two balls, not three. I just need to quit here. I don't agree. Just kick me off. Can I be on TV?
Sure. We'll swing a camera around for you.
I just want it to be about me.
Yeah. You know? There's a country song in there somewhere.
Yeah, there is. I got my dog back. I got my truck back. And my girl.
And a red Solo cup.
I got a clear Solo cup.
Yeah, but then people can see what you're drinking.
Well, kind of looks like, you know.
Looks like a 7 like and 7 of me.
Yeah.
No hesitation on that one.
See, that's where the cuteness kind of comes in.
Oh, okay, you know I got to make this, yeah.
You know, instead of giving that just a little left to bring it back to the middle table, he wanted to come back around. And it's not a bad shot, you know what I mean? It's a good shot to take, but the problem is he tries to get a little bit, well, I can come around three rails instead of just coming that simple. Come off that rail, come to the middle table, and you have the combo if you want.
Yep.
But... saying nothing about it. He's got
going
a great stroke. He's a great
going
player.
Going after the nine?
Nah, I don't. I think he's no.
Okay.
He's going to. He's going to go the route of running the table.
I think
if he doesn't make a mistake, well, he's got to get a good angle on this four ball.
Which Here we go.
Oh.
Here we, hang on a minute. We're going to take that here. We're going to look back at the production table here. There's Brian, the guy that's drinking 7 and 7s. There's old Jimmy boy.
7 and 7. I wish.
Yeah.
This, a little is later. This is my Red Bull.
Oh, God. It looks a little orange to me. I'm thinking you're pulling somebody's leg.
It's an orange Red Bull.
Okay, there you go. Mango.
Mango, it is. It's
is
good.
Is it a mango?
Stuff. Yeah.
Oh, God. I can't do that. My stomach doesn't make those things real well anymore. I get an old. Oh, nipples.
Oh, did he get away with it?
No,
he
didn't.
Yeah, it is. That's.
We'll see you later, boys and girls.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, you're not going to sit there and hold it?
Yeah.
You wanted me to hold that camera up there, so.
Yeah. Or just hang from it.
Yeah, just hang from it. Yeah.
Hi, Mom. Hey, Mom.
Got you covered.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Make you earn your dime.
I say to make the 2-ball, you have to make the 1-ball. And you just continue. You get credit for that ball. You get credit for that ball. You just continue to keep going through the rack.
Safety play. Did it come out good? Pretty good.
Is he gone? Or is
pretty
he
good safety. You can get a piece of it.
Play a safety on that?
Yeah.
You guys are going to go somewhere. You got to let me know. I got to keep this tournament running. I'm going to start forfeiting.
There's a shit on the floor. I picked them all up and all right, squished them down in there, but they're going to get overflowing real quick.
How do you put them? Exactly. More technical duties. You lost Brian to more technical duties. Follow him into the bathroom. Technical duties. Oh, yeah. The fun we have here at these tournaments. Oh, great hit. Ooh, doink. I could have stayed there. Great jump shot. Good hit. Sorry. Didn't do too
did
much, though.
He's a good jumper, too. When we played him in that Scotch Doubles, he made quite a few jump shots when his partner got him in trouble. Got good hit. Now, that was as funny because there was a shot that we saved, my partner saved him,
mm-hmm.
and he was able to hit a ball. You know, it was right there.
Mm-hmm.
But he opted to jump over the eight ball for a side shot.
Oh, okay.
I'm thinking to myself, why would you do that? Yeah. I mean, it just didn't make any sense. But he jumped it, drilled it right in the side.
Well,
I'm like, hey.
Yeah. Again, people see stuff so differently. You know?
Yes, they do.
May not work out so well.
Came up a little short there. Yeah. But the thing about it is with that shot is if he would have missed it, we had a wide open rack and there was nothing in our way.
So it's a
win,
lose, or draw.
It wasn't a smart shot, but he got away with it. You know what I mean? It's definitely not a shot that I would have even thought about taking. But, hey, he got away with it and it was a great shot. What's he going to do here? He might just try to play a safe, come back around. Bring that 5-ball up on the rail there. Bring the cue ball down to this rail, possibly.
Those are tough shots for me where you got to put the touch on it and make a big move.
Yeah.
Tough balls.
Yeah, see, that's what he's looking at is getting that cue ball down to that rail. Oh.
Too much. Looked good on paper, though. Didn't
yes, it did. Yeah. Yeah, so you hit that a little too hard because they didn't want the five to come back to that rail anyway. Sure. So if you would have just hit that a little lighter, it would have been actually a good shot.
Yep.
Yeah, he's on the hill, too. Shoosh. Doug's on the hill, so this could mean trouble.
Mm-hmm. Well, here you go with the theory. Shortest distance between mm-hmm. the ball and a pocket.
Yep.
And easiest thing to do with the cue ball.
Absolutely. Move that cue ball as little as possible. Mm-hmm. Do not roll it around the table a whole lot. Eef. That. Got away with it, but yeah, that was...
That nine ball is going to come into play.
Yes, it is. Well, I'm thinking. He's going to cut it. It's got it. Yeah, that's... I'm looking at the
maybe
angle.
Maybe not.
Well, no.
You're going to have to draw it. You're going to have to draw it. Put draw on it.
Yeah, if he puts draw on that, that's scratching right in the pocket.
Is it?
Yeah, it's... Yeah, he's... If he plays the left side of that pocket and cuts it, gives it an extreme cut, he'll actually hit where the chalk is.
Okay.
And... Yeah, he's still going to hit that night. That's going to be tough. That's... see?
Ooh,
oh, wow, he got away with it. Wow.
Short railed it.
Yes, he did. Wow. Oh, he missed it.
Oh no!
Oh, that's not a fun shot there. You know what? I guarantee Scott's gonna play the smart shot safety.
Mm-hmm.
He's gonna run right in that eight ball and pin him right up against it against the rail because that nine ball is gonna take away. Yep. It's gonna take away the bank, the kick shot. Because I don't think he's got. I mean, unless he has enough to try to cut that.
There's a little. I can see a little daylight to the corner, but gosh.
Yeah, it's off the rail, but that's still that's a tough cut.
And with a tight pocket, I don't know. Should yeah. just draw.
You know, with the reach, if he had a little bit of, I think he.
Mm.
I don't know if he called safe or if he's going to try to make it.
Draw. He's going to send her back up the table.
Wow.
Well. The old theory: over a ball on a rail.
Yeah.
You know. That's the best you can do. It's the best you can do. Kevin, yeah. He held it down there instead of bringing it out. So.
Yeah. Nick Karachi, Jay Johnson, table nine.
I thought for sure he was just going to run right into it and leave it pinned about. Yeah.
Yeah, but off a bridge, those kind of safeties on the bridge are tough.
Yeah, it is. That's very true. But, you know, here's the thing. You put a guy like this in this situation and make him make the shot.
Got to earn it.
And he
kind of like that.
Wow.
Oh.
All right.
Get okie.
Well, I got to go do the break.
You go do your technical stuff.
I'll do that.